your request on a sheet of paper and give it to the sheriff's officer, who will be standing at the jury door, jury room door, who in turn will give it to me. The officer will be sworn to perform certain duties, such as keeping you together in a private place for purposes of deliberation and ensuring that no one speaks to you except by order of the court. You are not to discuss with or ask the officer about trial matters or procedure. Please be aware that the officer is also instructed not to initiate communications with you or to enter the deliberation room without your consent, except to communicate on my behalf regarding administrative, such as information about breaks or meals or otherwise to ensure your comfort. If the officer must enter the deliberation room, she or he will knock first and just stop wherever you are, don't say anything, just let them in and they'll complete their duties without delay. once I receive your question or request, I'll go over it with the lawyers and we'll try to answer it as quickly as possible. Be patient. If you do send out a question, don't tell the officer what it is. Just tell them that you have a note and hand them a note. Never, ever indicate where you might be if you're voting, if you're deliberating towards a vote. Don't ever tell them that you're 12 to 2 or 8 to 4 on the given charge. Don't ever, just keep all of your deliberations to yourselves, all right? Now, once you've finished with the verdict sheet, in other words, you've got through all of the unanimous verdict, then you knock on the door, just let the officer know you have a verdict. Don't say anything else, bring it out. I've been reading these instructions to you. You are going to be given 3 copies to take with you into the jury room. Again, consider these instructions in their entirety, and I'll be available if you need any further assistance. Don't rely on the subheadings. They don't add any explanation